Welcome back, students. In this lecture, we are going to solve a few problems from the chapter of semiconductors. Okay, problems are an important part of your question paper. There are always, in every question, you find 5 marks numerical problem. And this, with a simple formula and some substitutions, you can get full 5 marks compared to derivations and other lengthy notes. Just a small problem can easily give you 5 marks. So do not leave problems in the question paper. Okay. So we are going to solve some simple problems based on the chapter of semiconductors, based on the formulas which we have derived. Okay. We have derived formulas for conductivity, current density, Hall effect. Okay. So most of the problems are based on these formulas. So the first problem, a pure germanium semiconductor has a carrier concentration of carrier concentration of electrons as 2.5 into 10 raised to 9 per meter cube. The mobilities of electrons and holes are given. Calculate its conductivity. So conductivity means sigma. Okay. Also calculate the current density if an electric field of 1000 volt per meter is applied across it. So we have to calculate two things here. First one is the conductivity, and second thing is the current density. So sigma, current density is conductivity is sigma, and current density is J. So these two things. What are we given? We are given that a semiconductor is a pure semiconductor. So pure means intrinsic. Okay. So this is a problem for intrinsic semiconductor. So we have to calculate sigma. What is the formula for sigma? Now since it's an intrinsic semiconductor, we are going to use a special formula for sigma. Sigma I. Okay. Sigma I, intrinsic conductivity, you can refer to the derivations of conductivity. We had obtained the formula for intrinsic conductivity sigma I as E into Ni into mu E plus mu H. Okay? So this was the formula for intrinsic conductivity. Here Ni is the concentration of electrons or holes, whatever, because it's an intrinsic semiconductor. Concentration of electrons and holes is same and it is represented as Ni. Mu E and mu H are the mobilities. Mu E is the mobility of electron and mu H is the mobility of holes, which are given to us here. So this is mobility of electrons mu E and this is mobility of holes mu H. So directly you can put this in this formula and calculate the value of sigma I. So E is charge of electron, which has a value 1.6 into 10 raised to power minus 19 coulomb. Ni is the conductivity, which is the concentration which is given to us here. It is 2 into 10 raised to 9 per meter cube. Please note, everything is already in SI units, so I don't need to do any convergence. Mobilities are 0.36 into plus 0.17. So you will just calculate this and this value will come out. So the value comes out to be 1.696 into 10 raised to power minus 10. Now this is the unit. Now what is the so this is the value. You have to also put a unit over there, conductivity. Always to get full marks, you have to put a unit. Only the value is not enough, but you need to put the correct units. Conductivity, what are the units of conductivity? Conductivity, if you remember, it's the opposite of resistivity. Okay, 1 upon resistivity is conductivity. So therefore, units of conductivity will be 1 upon units of resistivity. Now what are the units of resistivity? Units of resistivity, unit resistivity is rho, and units of resistivity are ohm meter. SI units of resistivity. So unit of conductivity therefore will be 1 upon ohm meter. So it will be ohm inverse, meter inverse. So this will be the units of conductivity. Then second part of the problem, we have to calculate the current density J. What's the formula for J? J is sigma into E. Very simple formula. Sigma I in case of an intrinsic semiconductor. So it will be sigma I into E. Electric field is given to us here. It is 1000 volt per meter. So we have to just substitute the values here. 1.696 into 10 raised to power minus 10 into 1000. So this will come out to be 1.696 into 10 raised to power minus 7. This is current density. So what are the units of current density? Current density, if you remember, the formula for current density is current upon area. So current is in ampere and area is in meter square. So ampere per meter square will be the units of current density. Ampere per meter square. So that's the final answer for your current density. Go to the next problem. It's also a similar type of problem. We have to calculate the concentration of donor atoms to produce n-type material with a resistivity of 0.2 ohm meter and mobility of 0.36 meter square per volt second. So now here we have to calculate the concentration of donor atoms. Now what are the donor atoms? Remember, for n-type semiconductor, you have to dope a pure semiconductor with pentavalent impurities. So pentavalent impurities are called as donor impurities. Why? Because they donate electrons to the semiconductor. They create extra electrons into the semiconductor. So that's why they are called as donors. So basically this question is, how many donor atoms you need to add to the pure semiconductor so as to get a resistivity of this much and mobility of this much. Okay? So for this, we have to again use a formula for conductivity. Because if you know conductivity, then you have to find, you know, resistivity. Resistivity and conductivity are inverse of each other. So, what is the formula for conductivity? Now, since this is a extrinsic semiconductor, we cannot use the formula for intrinsic conductivity. We have to use the general formula for conductivity, which is sigma is equal to E into N mu N, N into mu E plus P into mu H. Now, since this semiconductor is given to be a n-type material, okay, what are given to us, this is only the mobility of the electrons. So what is given to us is only mu E is given to us. Mu H is not given to us. And even concentration of holes is not asked over here. So in this semiconductor, which is an extrinsic semiconductor, we can safely assume that this part P and mu H is zero. Why? Because in an n-type semiconductor, the concentration of holes will be very, very small compared to the concentration of electrons, which is n. So P is very less compared to n for an n-type semiconductor. So we can neglect the second part of this equation, P into mu H, because it will be a very, very small contribution. N mu n will be a large contribution because it's an n-type. N is very large in an n-type semiconductor. So for n-type semiconductor, we can rewrite or approximate this equation to sigma is equal to E n into mu e. The other part is set to 0. It is neglected. So now, here we are given resistivity. We are talking in terms of resistivity. R is to calculate N, concentration. This is what is required to find out, concentration, which is N. So, resistivity is given to us. So, we can write that as formula in terms of resistivity as 1 upon rho is equal to E N mu E. And finally, since we have to calculate the concentration, so from this, what is N equal to? So, sigma rho can be taken up, and keep N this side only, take the other quantities on the other side, so it will become 1 upon rho E into mu E. So this will be the formula for N. So you just have to put the values now. So 1 upon rho is given to us as 0.2. E is 1.6 into 10 raised to power minus 19. And mu E, which is the mobility of electrons, which is given to us as 0.36. So this value will come, it comes out to be 8.68 into 10 raised to power 19. Now this is the concentration. What are the units of concentration? Concentration has units of SI unit is per meter cube. Number of charge per meter cube. So this many number of donors you have to add, donor atoms, donor impurities. 8.68 into 10 raised to 19 per meter cube. Donor impurities you will have to add to get a semiconductor, n-type semiconductor with this much resistivity and this much mobility of electrons. Next problem. A n-type semiconductor of thickness 0.1 cm having concentration of electrons as 2.5 into 10 raised to 21 per meter cube is used in a Hall effect experiment. So this is a problem which is based on the Hall effect. Having magnetic field of 0.7 Tesla, calculate the Hall voltage if the current of 0.5 amperes flows through the semiconductor. So we are required to calculate the Hall voltage. Also there is another second part for the problem. Also calculate the Hall coefficient. Hall coefficient is RH. And Hall voltage is VH. So these are the two things we have to calculate in this problem. So let's start with the first part to calculate the Hall voltage. What is the formula for Hall voltage? VH is equal to, formula is IB upon NET. Now, but in the derivations if you see it was PET because the derivation we had done it for a p-type semiconductor. For a n-type semiconductor, it just changes to n. P changes to n. Other things remain the same. So now over here in this problem, what is given to us? The current is given to us as 0.5 ampere. So 0.5 into magnetic field is given to us as 0.7 tesla. Then concentration of electrons is given to us as 2.5 into 10 raised to 21. Charge of electron is 1.6 into 10 raised to the power minus 19 into thickness is given to us in 0.1 centimeter. Now centimeter you have to convert it into meter, so 0.1 into 10 raised to the power minus 2. So that's the thing. So now what is this answer? So this answer comes out to be as 0.875. Now what are the units of it? Since this is a voltage, Hall voltage, so units will be volts. Okay, now going to the second part of this problem to calculate the Hall coefficient RH. Now RH, if you see the formula for it, it is 1 upon N into E. In the derivation it was 1 upon P into E because that was for a P-type semiconductor. For a N-type it will become 1 upon N into E. So it is very simple. So 1 upon concentration is given to us as 2.5 into 10 raised to the power 21. Into E is 1.6 into 10 raised to the power minus 19. So this will come out to be, this answer will come out to be 0.0025. Now, so that's the value. What about its units? What are the units of Hall coefficient? Now, units of Hall coefficient can be obtained from this formula itself. RH is 1 upon NE. I just show you in the rough column here how to find the units of RH. So RH is 1 upon N into E. You just have to put the units of these things over there. So this will become 1 upon, now N is the concentration. What are the units of concentration? Units of concentration are 1 upon meter cube, per meter cube. You can see from here. Okay, concentration has units of per meter cube. And E is what? E is the charge of the electron. 1.6 10 raised to the power minus 19 is the value and its units is coulomb. Charge is in coulomb. So if you rearrange this, you will get it as meter cube per coulomb. So that's the unit of Hall coefficient. So meter cube per coulomb. So that's your final answer for the Hall coefficient. I think with this we end the problem. So we have solved two types of problems in this chapter. One is based on the conductivity and the current density, the first part of the chapter, and the second one is based on the Hall effect, the second part of the chapter. Okay. So normally this type of problems you can expect, conductivity and current density, and second part is the Hall effect based problems. Thank you.